But you are directing us, especially recently, that we are supposed to use this world to reach the Creator, and not to use the Creator in order to feel pleasant in this world.
I didn't speak about the pleasantness. I spoke about the correction. If I go to connect with many people now, and I want to be in contact with them, whether it's inside the group or outside of it, with what force am I going to correct these relationships? With his force. How do I address a person? I have to see an angel in front of me, which means a certain character that I don't attribute anything to, but the fact that the Creator gave me an opportunity through him to correct myself, to relate to him like an angel of the Creator. And then how do I turn to him? How do I actually address him? Do I want to bestow to him or not? Because if it's a representative of the Creator, it's the external form of the Creator. So how I relate to the Creator and how I relate to him is one and the same. That's why it's called from love of the created beings to love of the Creator. And if you relate to him this way, you'll see that it's a... because they have no identity of themselves, you'll see that it's yours. Nothing is needed here but simply identifying that he's a representative of the Creator, standing between you and the Creator. If it's written from love of the created beings to love of the Creator, so between you and the Creator, there's nothing other than the fellow man, and the Creator set them up to be opposite to you in different ways, deliberately. And if you use them to reach the goal, that's what I constantly spoke about last week, aiming for the Creator. Because if you speak to the others as a representative, then you're really working with them in the only right way. Perhaps they'll show you all kinds of different, like a shell, you know, klipa, all kinds of different ways to overcome, to see the results, reasons, but it's in order to process that state eventually and have access to the Creator. And that's how you do it with another one and another one. Well, what does it mean that you're setting this up? You're actually building your soul because you're adding them to your soul. They're part of your soul. The Creator stands behind them. And all of these scattered pieces, the whole of humanity, are the pieces of the soul.
Now, why is it important to disseminate, especially before people? Why isn't it enough just to, for example, listen to the news, watch the news, can read newspapers? I'm also incorporated from their deficiencies and I can do the same work. Why do I have to disseminate in such a way that I have interactions with people?
Are you pulling them toward connection? Are you pulling the anchor, the news anchor, through the radio to connection?
I'm incorporated with a deficiency.
Who are you bringing this connected deficiency to? To the Creator, not to people. Show the sketch. What you get is that you do not connect to the people. You directly connect to the deficiencies of the Creator that He wants to give them. You're not headed for the correction of the world then. Then what are you doing? Who are you asking for? Where are those deficiencies which you have taken from the person by connecting to them? You have no connection with them. When you'll talk to them on the phone, it's not enough. Even with those people, don't meet them. Talk to them on the phone or through the internet. Today it's no problem. I immediately contact millions of people. I get deficiencies from them, asking for the Creator to give them. Won't help. Has to be real connection between people. It won't really work through the media lines. The connection, it has to be physical. You will see how all the technology helps us only as an addition. We will have to come to audiences. You'll discover that even though they really want to rely the future of the world and all the virtual connections, the connection between people will not come from that. There has to be physical connection.